Judge Hlophe reveals that Uzondo Arloko wanted me out of the judiciary at all cost, says Hlophe. Now, he is, look, as he was quoted or being speaking to, or I don't know, or by a Sunday World, or we're about to find out. Now, Sunday World report, there's a name, look, there's an article released by Sunday World on the 29th of June 2024 by Sandile Mota. The heading of the article says, Zondo wanted me out of judicial at all cost, Hlophe said. Now, let's read some of the things that are written here. It has been said that former Western Cape Judge President Mandlakayise Hlophe has thrown the gauntlet, accusing Chief Justice Raymond Zondo of masterminding his downfall. Hlophe is now the leader of Umkhonto weSizwe party in parliament. Right. Before we dive into what he said, it is very interesting that even the perception that has been created about Judge Hlophe, a perception that has been created about this the current Chief Justice Uzondo, you will often hear Mosuguti is often referred to as a celebrity judge, right? And the question is, why will people refer to him as a celebrity judge? There is a reason why he's being referred to as a celebrity judge. So it's some of those things that are worth interrogating. You know what I'm saying? But in this video, I'm going to go through all of the some of these things, right? So we'll talk about them in this specific video. But before I can do so, there are a few things that I'm requesting from you guys, and those things are this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contributing to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Okay. Now, Hlophe then says, Uthi, I never had any problem with Zondo. In fact, we came a long way. We served together in the Legal Resources Center at some stage. I even attended his wedding in Qobo with Ngobo, ex-Chief Justice Sandile Ngobo. So I was surprised when I was informed that he said I should step down from the bench. Hlophe vented. He was venting in isiZulu in one of the podcasts on social media. Okay, I did not see that one. I don't wanna lie. But thanks to his Sunday World. He said things that went well when the two judges of the Constitutional Court filed a complaint of judicial misconduct against him. They accused Hlophe of having unduly sought to influence a court matter relating to corruption charges against Zuma. He says at the time, the deputy president of the head of state, Thabo Mbeki. The two judges charged Hlophe had said, Sesithembekile Kanina, and in isiZulu phrase loosely translated, oh, utinla, Sesithembekinina. Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay. Says Tembeginina. Okay, yes. In look, as in isiZulu phrase loosely translated, as you are our last hope, right? It is believed that Hlophe uttered the words in attempt to influence judges, Judge Bas Nkabinde and Chris Jafta. This was an attempt for the judges to favor Zuma in their ruling. It was the very same phrase which was used to impeach Hlophe. Okay. So I won't go into much details about this, but let's just look at some of the stuff here. Hey, this thing, it is making a lot of noise here. So yeah, it has been said that I refuse because look, it says that Hlophe often credited with drafting a transformational agenda within the judiciary, also for calling for a legal system and underpin on African traditions and norms. He also said the Chief Justice Plus Langer had also offered him 10 million to leave the judiciary. Like, I refused because my fight was about the integrity and the justice system that serves all people. There was no way I was gonna accept that the money. I had done nothing wrong, right? So I think that is what I'm saying. I'm reading here. My interest with everything that has been said here is that it is quite funny that the if you look at the way things are actually transpiring as of now, when you look at Judge Hlophe and Judge Chief Justice Zondo in his position, I can almost tell you this. Just study the pattern, right? You will notice what I'm trying to say. It appears like we're going to have decisions that are going to be made by the lower courts, right? They may make decisions that even the electoral court, they may make decisions that will favor the MK party. But those decisions, when they are now taken into the, let me put a charger in my laptop. When they are now taken to the constitutional court, it's like we are most likely to see those decisions being overturned, right? So if then Judge Hlophe can be accused of influencing decisions in favor of Jacob Zuma, the same can be said then about Chief Justice Raymond Zondo, that he should be accused of making decisions that favors Ramaphosa, because there are decisions that doesn't make sense even today. Like, there are decisions that doesn't make sense, but they were made at the end of the day. So when are we gonna have the Chief Justice being held accountable for certain decisions that even today some legal minds are still questioning those decisions? One of them is the fact that you were willing to cut corners when you were arresting Jacob Zuma, sending him to prison. Why wouldn't you follow the right procedure? You're just eager to sentence the man, and you know what I'm saying? We have also seen, like this thing, it's a movie, if I may say. We have seen people who are on Zuma's side, like about Advocate Mkhweban, suffering a lot because they don't favor Ramaphosa, right? And we know they were impeached 1 month just to send a message that, you know what, I will influence decision in your favor. Who has been held accountable? Because that impeachment really made no sense. You could have just allowed the advocate to finish his her term, and then you're done. You know what I'm saying? But because you just wanted to revenge using legal processes, manipulating them, who has held those accountable?